Well, it's the first Monday of the month, and I think all of you who enjoy good food and know about cooking know that it is a Mary Berry Day on Good Afternoon. So hello and welcome, Mary.
Hello, Judy.
Today, actually, we're talking about pâtés. What is the difference? Sometimes, you know, when you go into these shops, which I think in France are called charcuteries, where you can buy pâté, what is the difference between pâté and terrine? Because the different labels confuse me.
Well, today, it's really the dish that it's cooked in. In the 18th century, it was in fact a pâté, had pastry around it, and was sometimes served as a pie, hot, and sometimes served hot as a minced pâté. And a terrine was a terrine-shaped dish.
I see. They're always as starters, really, these things, aren't they, for meals?
No, they're not. The first pâté that we're going to do today, Potters Pate, is lovely to have for lunch. We had it on Saturday. Even the four-year-old enjoyed it.
Really? That's as a main course. And of course, obviously, let's go over and start to see how you make that. But then you'd serve it, what, with just with toast or French bread and salad?
Yes, a nice salad. We actually had some coleslaw with it because at the moment salad things are rather expensive. So the joy of Potters Pate is that it's made from few ingredients, so there's not a lot to remember, and the basis of it is in fact liver and sausage meat, and the sausage meat is already seasoned. It has a binding agent with it, and it's
and
very
herbs
good.
And things.
So
in
you
it.
Use 8 ounces of sausage meat, 8 ounces of chicken livers, and that is actually the basis, and a large onion. Now you may laugh why I've begun to mince the onion with a bag over the top, but onions make me cry unless I do them underwater, or so I put a bag over so all the fumes haven't come up. And this is a portable mincer, so you don't need any special equipment necessarily. And if you just across the bottom of it, just dampen it, press it down on the table with a lock, and then we're away. So I've still got a little bit of onion to mince.
But in fact, of course, if you haven't got one of these, then you might have an attachment on a blender or a mixer if you have one.
That's right. And then to the other, and I take the bag off now because it doesn't smell anymore. I take off the elastic band. But I thought that was quite a bright idea because I was trying this pâté out yesterday and I was streaming my eyes in the kitchen. I suddenly thought, I'll pop a bag on the end. So just
very
tip it out.
Idea, that.
Just a washed out clean bag, polythene bag. There we are in the bucket. And then the sausage meat, and I'm going to mash those together before I mince the rest. And there's herbs, of course. If you buy sausage meat, you can buy sausage meat with herbs in.
Which I can see that has, hasn't it?
And it's well seasoned.
Is pâté good for freezing, Mary?
Well, not meat pâtés. I always use up within a short period of time. That is because it's got a high proportion of fat. In fact, a pâté should have about half fat and half lean. So mash, first of all. You'll find it goes in better if you mash at the beginning like this, before putting the liver. We don't want to use too many bowls, so I'll mince the liver straight in on the top of this.
Can you have pâté made of pretty well anything?
Yes, you can. You can do fish pâtés or meat pâtés. You can use the end of a carcass. If you have a roast bird, such as a chicken, or maybe a duck, you can use what's left and mince it through and then add other ingredients. Now the livers sometimes come attached to the heart, as that is, and so take it off and any little bits of fat. So put the liver into the mincer. And these are chicken livers, and often chicken livers are very reasonable. Just wipe my hands.
And easily bought in chain supermarkets.
That's right. All good butchers, because they usually have them, and they usually come in 8 ounce packets, so we're using 8 ounces of liver.
So it's equal amounts, 8 ounces of sausage meat and the 8 ounces of chicken liver.
Yep. That's right. And then the rest of the liver in.
I think you said you could make pâtés from rabbits to larks or something. Is that what
yes, you could make a packet of pâté of anything from In France, it's a lark or rabbit or venison, game, anything, as long as you've got the proportion right. And later on in the programme, I'm going to be making a true French pâté with some nice fatty belly of pork that's salt. You've got to be careful of the seasoning. There we are. So all that remains is the seasoning now. And I find using sausage meat that I use about a teaspoonful of salt, plenty of black pepper. I think it, technically that would be about a quarter of a teaspoonful. And then garlic. There we are. Thought I'd lost it. It's beginning to sprout at the moment. That must be the time of year. Just press it through the garlic mincer. Mm. Now you'll notice I didn't put that through the mincer because it wouldn't have been fine enough. So there we are. And then a good bunch of parsley, that's about a tablespoonful. Lots of green. And no herbs in this one because sausage meat has got one. And also this is very much, Potter's Pate is a family pate and every member of the family will enjoy it.
I think the great thing about it is the sausage meat takes away that very strong taste of liver which you can sometimes find in pates where the proportion is greater of the livers.
Now, Judy, to the lining of the tin, I find that about five, it makes extra moist if you use some bacon in the bottom. But if you're being very economical and you want it just for lunch, you can not line it with bacon, but it does make it extra moist. Then just, I've put two in already, just stretch these out a little bit.
That's streaky rashers.
That's right. Now you notice me break that one, I shall carefully put that one in first. I put four in. And the tin has been greased well with lard. And that just makes it extra nice when it's turned out.
Is that unsmoked or smoked bacon, Mary?
This was unsmoked, green bacon. Mm. There we are. Just room for that last one. Now to pouring it in. This is actually a £1 tin which takes about a pint of liquid. And you can do it in any tin. You can do it in a tureen. You can do it in a tin. And if you do it in an earthenware one, remember it'll take a little bit longer to cook.
Because it's got to get through.
And fill it right to the top.
The heat.
There we are. And it looks rather appetising with that nice green parsley.
Looks very good, that.
And then over the top, put a piece of foil. You may have a lid, but on this particular one, I haven't got a lid. There we are. And then I'm going to put that to cook in a tin of water. And so fill the tin with warm water halfway up the tin. That's a meat, just an ordinary meat tin, Judy. Mm. And then just fill it halfway up.
That's just so it doesn't go dry.
That's right, it keeps it extra moist. Mm. There we are, halfway up the tin. No more, because of course it would boil into the actual pate. And I'm going to bake that. Mm.
How long do you cook that for, actually?
Now, that is in a metal tin. Mm. Therefore, it'll be between an hour and a half at 325, gas number 3. Then take it from the oven, and as it comes out hot from the oven, put a piece of wood. Now, this is beautifully made. It can be thick plywood, anything. Just shape to the inside of the tin. That's what it looks like when it comes out of the oven. Then you've still got the foil on it there. Mm. And then put your block of wood, which fits the inside of the lid, you see. Mm. Press that down and then put weights on top. In this case, not too heavy. Just push it down until you just see the juices coming up to the top.
And that knits it all together.
That keeps it firm, and then it won't crumble when it comes out. Mm. And then let it get stone cold, and then turn it out. Mm. So obviously that has been in the fridge overnight, and it's ready to turn out now.
Another beauty about pate, of course, is that you can do it the day before easily, can't you? And then you've got your main part of your meal, as you say, you can use this as a main course, all ready without last-minute rush.
And also, it is better, Judy.
What, to leave it?
Yes. It'll come out.
Yes, there it is.
I always say it'll come out. It usually does, doesn't it? If not, we'll give it a good prod. Yeah. There we are. And the bacon does make it look much nicer. Mm. And it's just the finishing touch. Then perhaps a little parsley on the top.
Beautifully dressed. Shall I take that
in? And it'll keep well in the fridge for 3 or 4 days. Mm. And freeze if you must, but not for too long.
Right. I'll put that over here.
There we are. Lovely. Thank you very much.
Funny how a bit of green like that just dresses it up so nicely. And